Hello, my name is Amine. I'm from dSPACE Global Sales, and I'm very happy today to give you an overview of our RCP systems. RCP stands for Rapid Control Prototyping. It is a process that lets engineers quickly test and iterate their control strategies on a real-time computer with real I/O devices. The main challenges of RCP systems are to implement easily and quickly your ideas into real world, in a real environment, in real time. Let's take a look at our smallest prototyping system, which is the DCI Generic Serial Interface. The Generic Serial Interface is a device that can help you to monitor your internal ECU variable and integrate bypassing functions. It is also used for measurement for ECU calibration and flash programming. The next one is the Micro Auto Box. As you already know, this is the most common industry system nowadays. The Micro Auto Box is a robust system for both in-vehicle and lab users. It has direct interface to automotive devices and supports all automotive buses network interfaces. It contains Wi-Fi for dedicated host PC connections and contains also multiple I/O that can be extended throughout the needs of customers. The next compact system is the Micro Lab Box, which is popular for universities and research institutions. The Micro Lab Box is all-in-one prototyping system for the lab. It provides the most commonly used I/O for various use cases and is specially designed with a focus on electric motor control. It has more than 100 channels for high-performance I/O, which are easy accessible via the integrated control panel. So far for dSPACE compact systems, let's take a look at a more flexible and modular system, which is the Scalaxio Lab Box. The Scalaxio Lab Box is a modular, high scalable system with multiple I/O board slots. It can be easily adapted to various application and use cases by exchanging the corresponding I/O boards, as you can see here, and those are very future-proof even though the requirements are changing during a project. And just one more last thing, Autera. Autera comes from autonomous era, is a high-end brand new prototyping system for data-driven development. All these different systems cover different use cases. All mechatronics applications, for example, in the vehicle and in the lab. From A, autonomous driving for data-driven development, to Z, zero emission. Let's now take a look at one example for autonomous driving functions. What you can see here is a typical signal flow diagram for an autonomous driving function. The first step is responsible for the identification of the surrounding environment using different sensors, such as LiDARs, radar, and cameras. These sensors offer different advantages and have to be used as a complementary technologies to offer a robust solution. This is achieved in the second step, where the sensor's outputs are pre-processed by Autera as a prototyping system to produce comparable outputs that are valid for sensor data fusion. Now, let's say that the Ego vehicle was able to identify its surrounding in the best form possible using the data from all sensors. It is now time for trajectory planning and actuation control, and this is achieved in the third part, as you can see here by the Micro Auto Box 3. Using the available information about each of the identified objects in the scene, an algorithm can be derived to predict the intended trajectories of these objects and use this prediction in the decision-making phase. We can then, by the end, issue the control signals of the actuators of the Ego vehicle, like, for example, the steering wheel, the gas and brake pedals. Let's take a look at the eDrive use cases for RCP systems. So dSPACE offers powerful function libraries for processor-based as well as for FPGA-based design control algorithm prototyping. So the implementation software offers advanced I/O functions for example, AC motor control design like position encoder or multi-channel PWM. The tune chain provides easy implementation and debugging option for Simulink-based code generation and implementation. The hardware contains specific digital and analog IOs channels requires for your control prototyping needs. You can also use the same hardware setup for different model versions. Let's take a look now at a demonstration of an e-drive motor control. The demo consists of a permanent magnet synchronous machine with an incremental encoder and hull position sensor. We use the Micro Autobox 3 as a motor controller. The gate signals from the controller is sent to the inverter. The analog current measurements are sent back to the controller via this cable. The controller is interfaced via a power stage, which is the RapidPro hardware. The RapidPro contains three H-bridges for the three phases of the motor. Let's now jump in the model on Simulink. This is the complete model that is running on our controller. The model is divided into two parts, the FPGA part and the processor-based control part. The FPGA part is responsible for the signal conditioning of digital and analog input and output. The processor part has different subsystems. If we take a look, for example, at the controller task, so the controller tasks take the sensors which are coming from the FPGA, give the output to the speed controller, which is giving also the output to the current controller, and by the end, the output of the current controller is given to the actuator, which is responsible for PWM generation. If we go now to this yellow block, we will see our model port block. Here an example of buffer out, and this is the connection between Simulink and Configuration Desk. Now, let's take a look at Configuration Desk for quick. Here we have our project. If we go to signal chain, we have a signal chain which is divided into three main views, or three main components. External device is where you can add, for example, actuators. You have your function and function library. You can assign your hardware here under hardware. Here we have a Micro Autobox 3 as a controller. And for example, if we go to one analog in of the controller of the ADC type 4, we can go to property view and we can see analog voltage, range, and resolution of each channel, as we can see here. Now, if we take a look at the motherboard block that we just saw on Simulink, this is basically the interface between here and Simulink. We can go here and see the buffer out. Let's now see the application in action with the real hardware. We have Control Desk, which is the experiment software. The Control Desk has a layout that contains different plotters and graph and instruments. We have to calibrate the encoder offset from the beginning, just by clicking here, start. So the motor is searching for its initial position. Now, if we can see here, the control mode has both FPGA control and processor control. So if we go to processor control, we see, for example, the current control, the speed control. We can set up a load torque of 0.2 Newton meter, and we can set up a speed of, for example, 700. And we see now the motor running. On the left side, we have a graph that shows the speed of the motor, the reference and actual revolution per minute. And on the left side, we have a built-in oscilloscope. It is a graph that shows the phase current of the FPGA. We have also a drive safety setting so that we can save your electric component from damage, for example, for over-voltage or over-current. Here we can see the FPGA-based speed control. You can have a flexible approach of separating your model from processor side and FPGA side. That's all for today's demo. If you have any questions regarding RCP systems or dSPACE software, please get in touch with us. Thank you and goodbye.
dSPACE, your partner in simulation and validation.